To answer this question, let's think about what commits were present on GitHub and in your local repository before and after Git fetch. When you cloned the repository, the latest commit on it was Larry's commit adding the chili recipe, so that also became the latest commit in your local repository. Of course, there were other previous commits, but I'm leaving them out here for the sake of space. Now, you made a commit adding a new spice, so that commit is also present in your local repository, and that's where your master branch is. Origin slash master still points to the commit that was on the remote at the time that you cloned. After you cloned, Sarah added the no cumin commit on GitHub, but your origin slash master branch won't reflect that yet. So this is the state of master on GitHub. Now this was the state of both repositories right before you ran git fetch. So if you ran git log origin slash master, you should have seen that Larry's commit adding the chili recipe was present, but your commit adding a new spice and Sarah's commit removing cumin were not present on the origin slash master branch. If you ran git status, you should have seen that your branch was ahead of origin slash master by one commit. This makes sense because git log and git status both run without internet access. Suppose you were somewhere without internet access when you ran these commands. Your local git repository would have no idea that the cumin commit existed. So of course the cumin commit wouldn't be shown when you ran git log origin slash master. And git status wouldn't know that your branches were actually out of sync. It thinks that your branch is just ahead. Now when you run git fetches the no cumin commit and updates the branch origin slash master to point to that new commit. Your local master still points at the new spice commit like it did before. So at this point you have a local copy of the no cumin commit saved, and you can access it via git log. If you run git log now, you'll see both the no cumin commit and the chili commit. You still won't see your new spice commit, since that's only on your local master branch. Now since both origin slash master and master have one commit that is not present on the other, git status will show that your branch is out of sync with origin slash master.